Which brings us to the serious or not so serious business of tomorrow, the party for Australia's 225th birthday. Everyone is invited, of course. Miss Zoe Ford is on the harbour for us tonight. Miss Zoe, you've got in early and you've got one of the best seats in the house.
Isn't it spectacular, Sandra? And even when it's windy, Sydney Harbour is always beautiful. This afternoon, I'm standing on the Commissioner 2. It is a fantastic vessel and it is one of the many that will be out here on Sydney Harbour tomorrow for Australia Day. On this vessel, they're expecting 70 Irish guests, so good to see that they'll be getting into the Australian spirit. In fact, all over town today, you could really feel that excitement building from the setup of barbecues around the harbour to flags being hoisted on flagpoles, and then at Darling Harbour there was one very distinctive meat pie.
You can't get more Australian than a meat pie, and at 70 kilos this one's quite a mouthful.
It is a big challenge. You know, you need about 5 of my guys to carry it, to put in the oven.
You don't have to be a master chef for Australia Day though, and sometimes it tastes just as good if you're not. At Platinum Preschool they've been fine-tuning their Aussie taste buds early and learning a lot along the way. They even know more of the national anthem than most grown-ups. Best leave their parents on Barbie duties. Indeed, this is one of the busiest times of the year for the butchers behind the humble snag.
For the Australian Day, I do 1.5 tonne of sausages in 1 week.
Nationwide, we're expected to throw 7 million of them on the Barbie and eat more than 20 million prawns.
Oh, it's going to be huge. It's going to be massive over the next few days. Yeah, lots of people will be coming down here.
Lots of people will also be coming down here to the Australian Hotel at the Rocks, where the menu couldn't be more local.
We've got the specials on, coat of arms, which is half emu, half kangaroo pizzas. We've got over 120 beers, all Australian.
But of course, our National Day isn't just about culinary icons, it's about entertainment ones too. The new look Wiggles were in Hyde Park this morning ahead of their first Sydney concert.
We're doing some rehearsals and we've been practicing our songs and our new dances and we're ready for Australia Day.
So is the crew at Triple J, celebrating 20 years of the Hottest 100 countdown.
It's Australian as lamb or whatever, apparently. people love tuning in. It's a great look back over the year.
Who's number one?
Look, I'd tell you if I... Well, actually, I wouldn't tell you if I could. I'd probably use that information for financial gain.
Yep.
But I don't actually know the list, and so we really like counting down with the rest of Australia.
We'll just have to listen to find out.
So a lot to look forward to on Australia's birthday tomorrow. And just be mindful if you are planning to celebrate out here on the water that police will be out here too. Just as they're out in force on the roads checking for speedsters and drink drivers, they will be out here on the water making sure everyone's behaving themselves.
OK, Miss Zoe, thank you.